Man, how on earth am I gonna record videos with this racket? What's up, guys? Jason here, aspiring entrepreneur, showing you the day in the life of a budding entrepreneur, hustle building business, grind of creating content, and today the frustration of construction. So I have got to run out of my apartment and find a better place to record, which strangely enough happens to be three floors down underground in the parking lot where you cannot hear the jackhammer that is the construction. So today is not going too well because I was supposed to record all my videos for next week and the video that was supposed to go up today, Friday, because you know you're watching this on Saturday. So now I'm gonna have to do a Hail Mary on a video just off the top of my head for today and hopefully find a conference room to record in, because unlike a vlog, tutorial videos probably shouldn't be recorded in some random parking lot. So hopefully I'm able to find one, because it is late in the day, people are actually starting to get off work, and I did not have the foresight to reserve one. Well, out of luck on the conference center thing, but I did find a media room that was open, so hopefully no one reserved it for a early movie, because it is a Friday night. That's when most people, I guess, are having fun, as opposed to making YouTube videos and growing a business. Anyway, it's just one of those things. I know it's terrible lighting, but you can see in the background, you know, the construction going on. Things like this happen. I mean, it doesn't always work out all that great. So now I'm stuck coming up with a video kind of off the top of my head, because all the video ideas that I had lined up for next week, I need to do a tremendous amount of SEO, and I've just lost so much time. But this is one of those things where this is what it looks like. It's not always perfect, but you know what? We're gonna get it done. What's up, guys? Jason here, aspiring entrepreneur. And in this quick video, I'm gonna share three email tips with you for... Whew. And just like that, I've got the video for the day. And of course, after all of that, they finally stopped construction. So if I just waited another hour and a half, I would have been able to record all my videos. But now I am super late because I do have some family stuff this evening. And it's a part of that juggling, balancing act. But I wanted to end with introducing you to this concept that I'm working on called the value ladder. It's specifically applied to productivity, time, and emails, because I'm finding the more I try and get into client work, the more emails are just draining my day. I mean, emails have gone from 30 minutes a day to an hour and a half. So I definitely have a lot to improve there. And of course, I want to share those improvements with you. And so this value ladder concept, in short, is essentially assigning a dollar value to all of your tasks and all of your emails. So right now I'm working on a bracket of $10 an hour, $50 an hour, and $100 an hour work. And essentially, as entrepreneurs and business owners, we want to kind of eliminate all those $10 an hour work things as quickly as possible, and then eventually eliminate the 50, so we're only working on the 100 plus, right? And being really clear on, okay, I could do five or six things, or I could do one thing, and that one thing's probably the $100 an hour work versus the five or six things that's $10 an hour work. Of course, I've got more videos coming out on that, but I just want to share that quickly with you. So it's not always perfect, it's not always pretty, but you just got to get it done. So thank you so much for watching, and of course, until the next video, keep building the business you love. Take care.